Welcome to the Radical Racing Truck League here at Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Back to ovals again, on that road course turning right rubbish. And we got 50 laps here. And we start in 14th, which is pretty much at the back. Give or take a car or
get
two.
Get ready, going green.
Hopefully our race pace is better than our qualifying. Here we go.
Green, green, green.
So who's that? Daniel to the left, is it?
Car inside. Stay high. There's a car on the low side.
Oh,
clear.
Someone on the inside there. Whoa!
Car inside. Whoa. Clear inside. Car inside. Clear inside.
Oh, at least I didn't take people out there. Ouch, that wasn't good. You just got on the gas a bit too hard there. This is bad news. That was a heavy impact. This is going to be a tough race from here, guys. We need a caution. Well, I got into turn one quite high in the line that I've not taken and just got on the gas too early. I think the back end stepped around. I was heading towards Ashley. Managed to turn it away from Ashley, but managed to slam it into that wall pretty hard. The damage is quite significant on the right hand side there, and that's going to make for a pretty difficult race after doing that in turn one. Ooh, that's not turning. We need a caution. We need one sooner rather than later. I see smoke. Someone's turning left hard. Gabbing it up. Up to the left slipstream, that's Daniel. If we can stay in the slipstream, we might not be too bad off. We need a caution, we need to get these repairs done. Turn one, messed up my race in turn one, eh? It's a big track, so you can get a lot of repairs done in pit road in the time. Hey Wayne, welcome to the stream. If you guys haven't already, then do follow me, and that way you can get an alert each and every time we do this, which is every Sunday evening, same time. Wow. I normally mess it up by the first corner. I normally make a mistake somewhere, but first corner, that's been my worst starts. I was on the outside, just trying not to lose the position. Oh gosh, stay out of there. Well, thank you for the follow, whoever that was. Is it worth pitting and getting some repairs done sooner rather than later now? I'm going to keep doing that. Quicksilver, welcome to the stream. Way 92, welcome to the stream. Where's that caution? that's 10% of the race done already. We're going to need a caution to get any competitive finish. 12 seconds back is David. Behind him is John Jenkins, who had to start from the pit lane due to technical difficulties, and then had some issues in the stand, as he's at least a lap down. Trying to settle in a bit of a rhythm. We can lose as little time as possible. Feels like it's handling a little bit better now, which is good news. Graham coming out on the pits as he went through pit lane, didn't he? Six seconds in front is Luke. He is getting away from, especially down these straights, I think. So if we do get a caution, we're going to turn off the tyres and we're just going to get in there and get the truck fixed. And then pick up tyres if we have time after that. Graham's back in the pits by the looks of things. Had some issues, I think. Luke's in the pits as well. It's a bit early for a pit stop. We're not in a pit window. Unfortunately, Luke has had to call it a day. Guess he had some damage to his vehicle, despite the fact he was pulling away from me. So we're up to 13th place now. We're going to pick them off as they drop out. Probably do without this going green, and concerns me a bit that we're probably spaced out a little bit now, and might do. They will go green. It's time for everyone to start driving well, eh? Well, at least I didn't put it into the other cars. Eight seconds back from the car in front now, 7 seconds ahead of David. So he is closing that gap, but keeping it respectable, I think. Try to look after these tyres as much as we can. Losing the drop, lost it a long time ago. It's a long race, we've still got 40 laps to go. 20% of it done already, but we've still got a long way to go. Who's this 4 seconds ahead? Richard Wilde? Has he had a problem? He's certainly one of our quicker drivers. So if he's dropping back like this, then I think he's probably either spun or hit the wall. Is he heading for the pits as well? I don't get to use his draft at all, but he's heading down the pits as well. So I think we can do 35 laps. Tank. So I think we're getting... probably getting close to the pit window. That's what we needed. This first caution came out with Jake just losing it coming off turn four here. He was actually the leader at the time, so pushing very, very hard, and just lost it spinning to the inside of the track. Just enough on the racing line for iRacing to throw that caution for the safety of everyone involved. Bad luck with that, Jake. But I really needed that caution, so thanks very much. Right, let's get all of our repairs done. I've turned the tyres off so that we can concentrate on the hammer work. Should be all right to get that done. So if we top off with gas, got the next wave of time around.
600, 15 car.
Let's have a look at our tyre wear. We got 91s, 85s.
Sorry, Jake, I'm dreaming, buddy.
Whoa, new sped there.
Yeah, I can believe that, Jeremiah, to be honest, because, you know.
Right, topping off with gas. Four tyres. Going to grab top off. Oh, blimey. It's fine. So lap 16 restart. We are in 13th place, but we have topped off with fuel. And grabbed four tyres and got all the repairs done.
Jake, just go on the outside of me on the restart.
Get ready, going green. The pace car is in. Green flag, green flag.
Right, off we go.
That car's a lap
down. Inside, clear inside. At least we didn't hit the wall this time. Didn't do that corner very well though. So up to 13th and we can see them now. Now we're not going to be perfect because our car is still going to have a little bit of damage. But it's definitely better than we were. It's a bit tight at the moment actually. New tyres, that's a bit of a worry. try to look after him. Yeah, we're good for, we are good for fuel. Pretty certain of that. Let's not worry that apex at all then, shall we? No! Oh my goodness. Thought I was making it down there. Unbelievable. Could have turned it tighter as well. I thought we were clear. Maybe I'll loosen the truck up a little bit. It still feels tight. Definitely started coming to me though when we were racing with a slightly wrecked truck. That's the apex a bit closer anyway. Still couldn't get on the gas until late there. Handling quite as nice as I'd like. We're definitely faster, look, our time there is quicker than we've done so far. Mr. Jenkins will be wanting fast. He's still one lap down, I think. He's got a clean truck. Oh, blimey. Let me know when you want past, John. No, but I could use your draft. If you think you're quicker, mate, because you've got a clean truck, haven't you, then I think you should go by. Yeah, you're going to need to go by. I'm really tight in these corners. Come down the straight. Inside.
Car inside. Still there. Clear inside.
Right, let's grab this bit of draft for as long as we can. Right, David is 2.5 seconds ahead. Smoke there, but nothing doing. Yeah, not going to hold on to this draft for long, I don't think. Do you know what? This truck actually drove, or felt like it drove better with more damage. I guess the times were lower though, weren't they, but felt okay. Graham's truck finally succumbed to the damage that he received somewhere. I think our best bit is actually going to go green, because John Jenkins will get back on the lead lap, and he has got a faster truck. So I guess it's a good time now to mention that I set up an iRacing Fox Fantasy NASCAR game link. If you want to join that, then the link is in the description below if you watch on YouTube. Just where you pick who you think is going to do well in the real life NASCAR. My wife and I played it last season and we were just 20 points difference. I only just beat her. Would have been embarrassing if she'd beaten me. To be fair though, she knows her stuff when it comes to NASCAR. Definitely lost the draft at the moment. So if you haven't already, say hello in the chat. It's always nice to see who is talking. If you're watching on YouTube, then leave me a comment, say hello. Usually I'm a little bit more in the thick of it.
The yellow flag is out.
There's a yellow flag.
This road is closed.
Right. If we stay out, we'll get run over. There is some smoke. Oops, someone's reversing in pit road. There's some damage. I think there's quite a lot of people involved in that. At least 2-3 cars, I think. I'm going to turn the gas off. Right down. There we go, right down. Let's just take a bit of... We're not going to need it now with this caution though, are we? No, we're going to take 4 tyres. And we're trying to get the rest of these repairs done and see what happens. Another caution that we needed. This caution came out where Sir Hill and Josh were battling really hard here for second place. Looks like Sir Hill just lost the back end and Josh hadn't given him enough room for him to be able to cope with that, and they ended up coming together down the front stretch there. Jake manages to avoid the wreck but gets in a bit of a spin, doesn't hit anything. Oh, it just about hits the inside wall there, not too much damage I hope. Just a bit of a wrinkle of the bodywork there. Other than that, got away with
mentioned
it.
Here for Ian Cornish, who manages to avoid the wreck, keep control, not end up going down the pit road and get back onto the racing groove. Not a scratch on his truck, some great reactions there, well done Ian. But the really scary incident was where Andy, going through thick smoke, keeps his foot in the hopes to get through, unable, hits Josh and ends up hitting that pit wall, launching himself towards the crowd. Luckily the catch fencing which was installed there protects the crowd perfectly. Not even one of them flinched. These Indianans are pretty made of stern stuff. Atrock's gonna need a bit of a crane to get it back into the race.
Okay, we're halfway to the finish.
That's pretty good. .4 of a second of damage. lap 29 restart. We're in sixth place. A lot of people had some damage, I think, that they needed to fix in the pits. We're on the outside, though, which is a bit of a worry. So we need to get to the inside if we can.
The pace car is in.
To four tyres, got all the repairs done. So, oh, bad start, bad start.
Green flag, you're in the top 10.
We'll protect our inside. I think Stewart's gonna grab it from me. Didn't say inside. I left a lane though. There's the inside line.
Stay high. There's a car on the road side.
Whoa! Missed the apex.
Stay high. There's a car on the road side.
Let's slot him behind there. Come on.
Car inside.
Come on.
Still there. You're up top, three wide.
This isn't working well.
Hold your
I expected them to be gone by then.
Clear inside.
I prefer it with a bit of damage on the right hand side personally.
Still there. Hold your line.
Whoa.
Clear.
I think we might be last again. No, we didn't hear anyone. Just got some damage on lap one, turn one, and it was pretty heavy. Down to 12th again. Just couldn't get to that inside properly and hold it. We're gonna need some more wreckers up front, I think. You'd be slightly more competitive than this. Well placed. What can you do? You know, you got to keep going. Gonna pick up a spot or two, maybe. As long as you don't throw it at the scenery, which is what I'm threatening to do. It's actually going to be our fastest lap of the race, which. Just bode well that the truck is in better condition than it was at any other point in this race. Well, that's about a second down on where I should be, or could be, or was in qualifying, I think. So there's definitely damage to the truck that is limiting our top speed. There's a big gaggle in front. Bramish, welcome to the stream. You missed the start, mate. Well, things were going really well. Apart from the fact that I qualified pretty much plumb last, everything was going absolutely perfectly until the first corner. Then things went downhill pretty quick. I was on the outside and I gave it a bit too many beans too early on, and back end stepped out and I nearly turned into the guys on the inside, saved it, but it just flipped me into the outside, hit the outside wall side on, and did 48 seconds of damage. Limped around until the caution came out, got all the repairs done, got all the tyres replaced, and topped off a couple of times with fuel, which would get us to the end of the race. And then on the restart, found that I still didn't have a great deal of speed in the truck. And then hit the wall again a little bit, little tap, 0.4 of a second worth of damage. In the next caution, got that 0.4 of a second worth of damage done. Grabbed four more tyres and just restarted sixth place. There was a few other cars who were involved in incidents and were in pits for an extended period of time to get themselves repaired. Started on the outside. And went backwards pretty quick. So not the greatest of races. So, in the meantime, as there's not a lot of overtaking to show, but we're hoping there might be something still to go. We've still got 15 more laps to go. Been asking people, where did you find my stream? Did you find YouTube first, or my stream here on Twitch? What made you pick my races over all the other iRacing races that are out there? Alan is 3.6 seconds ahead of me. We're going to keep an eye on that and see whether that extends or contracts. Someone right over the left hand side there. Did they hit the wall? Connery, did he hit the wall? Did he recover that? John Jenkins as well, was he involved? Both seem to be going slowly. Are they carrying more damage than me right now? Have we got a couple of spots that we could feasibly make up here? Or are they just going to drive away from me now? 2.6 seconds ahead. Let's see how we get on. Well, I think Connery might have hit the wall again. 2.6 seconds ahead. Yeah, I guess UK drivers generally are more road racers, I guess. Murray is not getting far away from me, so we've got a chance. He's pulling a little bit, just probably because he's just in the stream of he's in the draft still, probably. Wow, didn't hit all there. He's probably done. We got a wreck. A couple of guys. One guy. Alan. John Jenkins was involved, but it looks like he's escaped most of the problems. Let's see if I can stick in here. Bramish says that he watches my stream to study the position, what the leader's going by or something. Not many people have to worry about me as competition for that. So Alan is now 12.8 seconds behind us. He has got going. And we'll have to see whether he got any damage, whether he closes that gap. John Jenkins, ooh, we need to make sure we don't hit this wall here. We'll lose a bit of time making sure we don't. Whoa. Apparently we did hit the wall. Just swapped a little bit of paint, that's all. John Jenkins, 1.9 seconds ahead. Alan, 12.7 behind. Not doing too badly. Tight there, not getting around the corner very well. Yeah, Bramish, how's your week in racing been? Bramish does quite a lot of official racing, and there's the yellow flag. Ten laps to go. What? That is going to make things exciting. This caution came out. Jake is pushing really hard at this stage. Get some heavy contact on the right hand side there. Maybe that caused the tire to go down or something, and he lost it in turn three. Some good maneuvering around there, around Jake there, and then just ends up knocking against the inside wall. Okay, lap 45 restart. We took four tyres and got all of our repairs done again.
Get ready, going green.
We're in ninth place on the inside this time, so with any luck, we'll have a bit of a better start. I'm just so late on the gas every single time.
Good job.
Whoa, that was a bit rough, wasn't it, Mr. Jake?
Clear outside.
How did that not cause a wreck? Whoa, understeer. Didn't hit the wall this time. Excellent. Come on.
You've got 5 laps to go.
Well, 5 laps to go. Whoa, cars everywhere. They all held it. That's good going.
Car outside. Clear outside. Car inside. Still there. Clear. Car inside.
Whoa.
Still there. Clear inside.
Come on. Whoa, we hit that wall very hard that time.
Outside. Clear.
Was that 7th now? Come on. or smoke.
Slow car ahead, slow car down low.
No. Oh, no.
Line up, single file.
Hard lines are in, you just caught the curve.
The 46 car.
Sixth place. Is that it? That's it, isn't it? Jenkins in the middle car with Connery on the outside, hits that wall and basically stops in front of John Jenkins. He runs into the back of him and then Jake runs into the back of John Jenkins. John Jenkins' truck is a bit of a mess. Connery's is not an awful lot better. John Jenkins is losing a lot of speed in the straightaways here. That caused quite the damage to him. As I showed before, Jake Foster runs at the back of John Jenkins in his attempt to avoid the wrecking cars in front, but manages to hold a really good line really around there, the back end coming around, but holds it. Unfortunately, did catch a bit of the wall. And it's adding to the damage of his truck. His truck's been in the wars a little bit in this particular race. As Jake starts a new lap, his beat-up truck is really beginning to beg for mercy and just wouldn't make it round the corner there. And that was a really heavy impact. Cheers, Jake. Thank you for staying high up there. That was, with your lack of speed, it was courteous of you to do that without blocking. But Jake's truck is pretty much going backwards now. Little bit of more problems with Jake's truck. He's fighting to keep hold of it now, and it finally gives up traction and dives to the inside, ending the day for that truck. Caution came out where Ian Cornish was battling very, very hard with Daniel here for third place. Just got onto the curbs and ended up throwing him into the outside wall there. I think David managed to get a bit of contact with him as well on the way through, but that did bring out the caution that ended the race. Just viewing the final incident behind David's truck. Yeah, Ian struggled to keep hold. Looks like a bit of net code there as well, saved David, but that could have been very bad for David. Has managed to escape that incident. Once again, many congratulations to Jeremiah. Class of the field again, leading 28 of those laps. Four cautions, not too bad. So Hill in second place, Daniel in third, Stuart in fourth. Myself managed a sixth place finish. After lap one, corner one, I'm really quite pleased with that result. I did a lot of damage in that first corner and affected me throughout the race. We managed to get across the line. Never give up. Keep on going. Well worth the finish in the end. League table. This league table here shows, without any drop weeks taken into account, shows Daniel Page in first place with Stuart in second and Jeremiah in third. Now, I believe Jeremiah's missed a race, so he will probably be the leader, I think, after the drop weeks are taken into account. I managed to drag myself up to a fourth place at the moment. Next race is at Phoenix International Raceway, the new track, the new layout. At the moment, it's going to be with the open dogleg, but that's under review just to make sure that we're happy with that. I'd be interested to put in the comments whether you think we should go with the open dogleg or not. And join us as always on Sunday night on Twitch.tv/JarrettUK. Aim for about 8:45. You get the end of practice and the qualifying and the race there, and come and watch the races live. If you're interested in the Fox NASCAR fantasy game, then join League 25319 and compete with me and hopefully many others to see who knows real NASCAR the best. So thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you next week from Phoenix. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider giving me a like. It really helps my videos. If you haven't already, then do subscribe to my channel to get more updates of when I've put some races up. And if you'd like to give me some feedback on this particular video, then please put them down in the comments below. Thanks very much for watching.